Good day for all. This is the second part of the accelerometers and double integration presentation. We will present some simulations that corroborate the theoretical analysis we did in part one. Let's try to remember what we did before. The idea was to use the spring deflection measurement to estimate the position of the vehicle. We say that the spring deflection measurement cannot be used directly, but that we have to condition it with a filter Ks that requires an integrator to obtain an estimate of the vehicle velocity. Then, the use of a second integrator will allow us to obtain an estimate of the position. We mentioned two filters Ks. The first one is indicated here. This one is an integrator with a gain that guarantees zero steady state velocity error when the input is a step function. And this is the second one, derived from the zeros of the system. The parameter t is a design parameter that needs to be small enough. Ideally, if t equals zero, no error will be observed, which is not possible. We have here the numerical values for the simulation, including the value for the input force, and the time constant t of the second filter.
With the numerical values you just have provided, we can predict the position errors for both filters by using the final value theorem. For the first filter, we have this expression and the final value 8.88 meters, and for the second this other one with a final value 1.55 meters. Then, our simulations should match these final values. Here we have our simulation model for the first filter. Our input F, the vehicle plus the accelerometer, are three state variables, the filter K, S, the velocity error and the position error. Now we run the simulation and check our results. As expected, the velocity error converges to zero. This is very important because any offset or bias in the velocity estimate will produce a drift or divergence in the position. Here we can verify the final value of the position error, which is close to the calculated value. This is the simulation of our second filter. Everything remains but the filter K, S. Let's run the simulation. Again, everything looks as expected with the velocity error going to zero and less position error. Let's verify that. The final position error approaches to the theoretical, as expected. For the last simulation, we are going to estimate the vehicle velocity using a Lauenberger observer. We have our plant, vehicle plus accelerometer, and our observer as two separated subsystems. The spring deflection measurement is an input to the observer. The external force is the other input to the observer. The observer produces, then, an estimate of the vehicle velocity. With this estimate, the velocity error can be obtained and integrated to get the position error as before. Let's run this simulation. We can notice that the responses are much faster now. The observer settles in less than 4 seconds, whereas before it responded with the time constants of the original system. This is the observer response when the initial state of the plant is different from the state variables of the observer. Here we can see the initial conditions of the plant. and the initial conditions of the observer. The observer performs better because it is a feedback, controlled, mechanism that requires perfect knowledge of the plant and the input. The filters of the previous simulation were open-loop mechanisms that required only knowledge of the accelerometer parameters. An observer guarantees zero error if it has perfect knowledge of the plant. We need to remember that any mismatch between the observer and the plant would produce an offset or bias that, when integrated, would make the measured position to drift away from its real value. Let's observe again the position error for this initial condition. Notice that if there were no mismatch between the initial conditions of observer and plant, the observer would follow the plant perfectly. The final value of the position error can be also calculated theoretically.
To wrap up this presentation, I would like to ask you this question. Are accelerometers ideal instruments to measure position?
I think that is a rhetorical question, since I believe you have an answer for that question already.
Precisely. The answer is that we wish we had something better. Unlike other sensors, in which a static relation exists between the measurement and the physical variable we are interested in, an accelerometer has a dynamical relation through two integrators. Integrators, we must remember, are poles at the origin that edge the instability zone of the S-plane.
I can see your point. For this simple example, we have shown that theoretically, we should expect, in the best of the cases, an offset in any position measurement using an accelerometer. This offset is not constant, it depends on the dynamical conditions of the system, which change every time. In the worst of the cases, when the first integrator presents itself a steady state error because our dynamical representation of the plant is imperfect, which is probable, the position measurement will eventually diverge from the real position. An increasing drift is observed in this case. Nevertheless, I assume that some error is permissible depending on the application.
That is right. We will have to check that error from now and then, and if we have the means, reset it, so it will never drift too far. We have considered here a simple deterministic dynamical system. Things get worse when we know that real-life measurements are noisy. Usually, noise is modeled as Gaussian white noise, that is, a sequence of independent, normally distributed values. We know that when we numerically integrate white noise, we obtain a random walk whose variance increases with time. Therefore, a drift will occur with just one integrator. When we take into consideration the stochastic properties of the measuring process, we need to use a Kalman filter observer along with extra signal processing to minimize the random walk drift.
Why then accelerometers are still in use?
Mainly because of the lack of fixed references in large spaces where the vehicle travels. And when there are some fixed references available, like a GPS, they may not be enough to stand alone for the application. It is common to see inertial navigation systems aided by other measuring systems. The fact is that current navigation systems are very reliable. We are going to continue with the topic of navigation in an upcoming video. We will consider the more general case to navigate on Earth, and why not, maybe out in space, the final frontier.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its 5-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.